morning. It's way earlier than we normally do this. This is normally like a 1 p.m., 1:30 sort of thing. But we're about to get absolutely whacked by the tail end of a storm out of the States. And so it's happening early. Though, based on how gross it looks outside, I don't know that I've started this early enough. I think we might still get absolutely whacked by the storm during this live. So, it's a pretty complicated piece this week, and I'm not totally feeling it. It's more complex than I wanted, so we're going to, quote-unquote, cheat it, and I'm going to use the 31 purple fish paints. And sort of like cheat all the little like flowery shrubby bits with colors that granulate so that I don't have to work nearly as hard. I also apparently don't have masking fluid, so the Winsor Noon white gouache is potentially going to come into play because I don't actually have a white paint in this set. The closest I've got is eggshell. But I don't know that eggshell is opaque enough to work as a white gouache in this case. We're going to find out. So, I also haven't decided on paper. It's a bit of a hot mess this morning, this live. But we're going to deal with it. So, paper. I have two options. Also, I have two new guppies that need to go away. I haven't swatched them yet onto their hex cards to go away. I also, like, haven't put away colors in the 31 Purple Fish palette since I got my January? Nope. But December. That's December, guppy. And these two are shimmery, which is why they're down here. They're not in the rest of my palette. So, paper. We have two options. We have square. Or we have Baohong. I'm leaning towards the square because the image is a square, but the Baohong would give me more space. So, I don't know. Oh, do I want more space or do I just want to paint the same scale? I think I might just want to paint the same scale as it is. So, let's just use a square. I feel like we've been using a square for all of these recently. It's just like a good size. Oh, I'm almost out of square paper. I've decided that I don't like the Paul Rubens pads that I bought to replace the Baohong paper and the big pads that was out of stock. My ink doesn't dry on it for whatever reason. So, coffee. It's too early in the morning to not be having coffee. Yeah. So, let's tape out this square. Do I want this size of tape? No, but I'm also too lazy to find something else. That's where we are this morning. Straight, maybe. We'll go with that being straight. Not straight to me, but it looks straight-ish on camera, which is really what's important. Is it massively storming where you guys are as well? I know it's we're getting the tail end of a storm that's hitting, I think, most of the southern United States. So, it's definitely hitting a good number of people. Didn't come all the way across. Normally I wouldn't care that it doesn't cover the entire edge, but I feel like this is going to be really messy, and if it doesn't, like, it could be problematic. So we're going to make sure that as much is covered as possible, just so that hopefully I get a clean tape pull. I feel feel like it's, has it been a while, or does it just like feel like a very long week at this point? I don't know. So, barn. We need a barn to be sketched in here. Am I going to be really annoying and sketch in all of these like lines? I think I'm going to be really annoying and sketch in all of these lines. Sure. There. There's a little barn in the hillside. And now it like this is gonna be the art of like doing a bazillion layers. Let's start layering random stuff. What do I want? I want the greens, which is not this. I want to say it's this one. Nope. Pinks and purples. Such a pretty color palette, though. So let's open the greens. Ta-da! All the pretty greens. I think I'm going to start with Sage Haze for this. And then I'm going to dot in other stuff. But I want to start Moody. Ditch all these brushes. Because, yeah, Sage Haze is what I want. I should have pre-wet these, but whatever. I think for March, so she does collections, and March is greens. Because April and September are purples normally. I think she announced on Instagram yesterday that March was going to be greens. Which is very exciting because it'll mean she's going to release probably several brand new green colors. Probably not the brush to be doing this with. Where's my number six? There's my number six. One thing I like about this paper is that it sort of like takes abuse better than some of the other cheaper papers. I'm gonna like just like do a bunch of layers of this. So we're also going to throw in some Lunar Moss. As you can see, though, like, everything's just, like, sort of having its moment to sort of do its thing. And actually, it's so pale that the camera's having an issue picking it up, sort of. That's annoying. Oops. Didn't mean to do that. I want something even darker. I want grass haze. Realizing I should have a swatch card. I don't think I do. All right, there we go. I faked a meadow. Ah, I do have a swatch card. So, Stonehenge, Legion, mini pad. They're just always my go-to size for this. They work really well. And I'm just gonna swatch as I go. And for once, I'm letting it dry naturally because I want, like, these crazy blooms. So I'm going to let it dry naturally, which is going to take a while. So if you have any questions about these paints or other paints, feel free to pop them in the chat. Color am I going to use to label? My fountain pens are actually full. We're going to use this. I think this is Blue Yosemite Falls. This is the new Ferris Wheel Press Feathered Flight pen, but it's a carousel pen just in blue. So this is. Oh, I love that color. It looks so much darker in this pen than it does swatched out. So, let's tuck that up there. I guess I could do sort of the sky section because that's really not going to change all that much. And, like, anything that gets added to it is just going to, or, like, any bits that get covered are just going to be, like, the mountains. So, I'd start that, then, like, we get to sandwich in the other part. So, I'm going to pull grays as well, but I'm also going to use smoke blue. Which is often what I use. I might actually just use smoke blue. And winter's gray, actually. Winter's gray has got a little bit of a purple to it. There. So, I would say smoke blue is probably one of my most used colors in my palette, especially for like skies. And then winter's gray. I want to see if I can do this without the permanent white. I know I pulled it out, but now I want to see if I can do it without. Smoke blue, winter's gray. A fountain pen that I did not get the converter in properly after I filled it up, but it didn't leak, so it's fine. I love how this is drying. I don't love how that's drying. And then I need a dark, dark green. I'm leaning towards forest olive. For this entire tree section, that top clad bit's still too wet for it to go on. And then I need the barn color. What color am I going to do with the barn? Oh, we're gonna do the barn maple haze. Actually, let's add these quickly. Olive green. No, olive haze. And maple haze. That is exactly why I love them too. They are so moody. It's almost dry, and then we can do the next section. dry enough. I think we're dry enough that I can erase part of these lines, if nothing else. So I didn't get my clouds exactly as far down as I wanted here. And so I'm just going to erase, and that's going to become my new mountaintop, which is something that I love about watercolor and kneaded erasers, that I can just simply like make my new horizon line. Nope, you're still wet. I don't want them to bleed into each other, but like I also want to keep like developing these spots, which will only happen if it dries naturally. So for once, I'm having to be patient and let stuff dry, which I never do, or rarely do. Do I have paper to make more guppy cards? No. Oh, so I'm just stuck here. I think potentially this afternoon, but if not tomorrow, there'll be a live stream of putting the palette back together, because it's become a mess with the past few projects, specifically the single pigment paint projects, because I was just pulling colors for the last several and not putting stuff away. So I think there'll probably be a live stream either this afternoon or tomorrow where I put stuff away. So that'll be fun. Nope, we're still wet. Ugh. Such enthralling content. Such enthralling content on this channel at times. I never let anything dry normally. Or if I do, like, I wander away and do other stuff. Oh, I can show off my new tiny detail brush. So this is a Dynasty 000, which is the smallest 000 I have ever seen. It is, as I drop it, so thin. I don't even think the camera's picking it up, potentially. It's such a great brush. I absolutely love it. I used it a whole bunch in a project recently, and it's great. I needed a new 000, and I couldn't find any of the common ones that were great or had bristles that weren't damaged. So I picked up this one, and it's absolutely fabulous. Oh, we're still wet. I think everything, all of these palettes. There's 31 purple fish, like this goes up here, which means this all needs to be reorganized. Basically, I think every palette, everything moves. Sometimes, like, I can just slot in colors, but I don't think that's the case this time. Just with where colors are having to go. Oh, we're getting there. So in the hot pink, I think strawberry peach. Honestly, it goes like here between Potter's and Pink Salt. But I might be wrong. I need to do the proper swatch cards for them. For this palette, like I've done my normal swatch cards for them, but for the 31 purple fish paints, I pretty much only use the magnetic swatches, because they just are what lives with the palette. Okay, we're going to call that good enough, mostly because my patience is running out. I'm sort of done. All right. Once this has dried, I will go in and I'll do the barn. In red. Not in red. In maple. Maple haze. quite like it so far. I like that better. Nope, the green's almost dry. There are like fence wires in the original, but they're so faint. And I don't feel like doing them, is the honest answer. So I'm not going to do them. I also don't know that my hands are still enough to do them today, so it's just not going to happen. Plus, they're at, like, the very front, and I don't want to screw it up at this point. So, I'm not going to do them. I'm just going to do the barn and then leave it at that. I was going to, like, tidy up the trees that have bled. I don't know that it's possible, so I might just leave them. Oh, never mind, they just lifted right off. Okay, I'm actually gonna dry this. I know I said I wasn't going to, but now that I've fixed that section, I just like don't want to have to worry about it. Tiny detail brush. Maple haze. All right. Here we go. Done without the use of masking fluid. I think, though, I had tape bleed on this side. I didn't! Ha! Look at that. Look at that. Well, that's this week's Paint Your Style. We only use 7 colors. I think it's quite cute. As always, the close-ups will go on Instagram. So if you want to see a close-up, the pictures will be over there. And thanks for watching.